the pine, taste the warm of winter wine, dream of softly falling snow. Winter's gold, aspen glow. Winter's gold, aspen glow.
Thank you very much, and good evening, everybody. Welcome to my Rocky Mountain Christmas. I'm very excited about this television special because this time I get to show you a little bit of how beautiful the Rocky Mountains are, and I can share with you the real joy that I feel of just being able to be home with my friends at this special time of the year. And I didn't want you to think that snow has always gotten Colorado. We saved a little bit of the Colorado springtime for you. What do you think of our set here, you guys? Is this far up? What we did is we built a transparent bubble and placed it in the middle of a snow-covered meadow in the Rockies. And outside, as you can see, it's snowing, it's cold, and in here we've got flowers and growies and greenies and little butterflies floating around. Hi there. Come on, right there. Oh, far out. How are you doing, little guy? We've got a lot of fun for you tonight. A lot of music, a little bit of skiing, a little bit of ice skating and some snowshoeing. And I've got some very special guests this evening. First of all, from way, way down south, down under in Australia, Miss Olivia Newton-John. I have my good Colorado friend and skiing buddy, Steve Martin. Weird old Steve is here tonight. And my very special guest this evening, a very lovely and talented lady, Miss Valerie Harper. So stick around and enjoy our Rocky Mountain Christmas with us. Thank you.
Beautiful. I have to tell you, I'm in paradise, man. I'm on top of the Rocky Mountains. I got my friend the Sun over here. We had new snow last night. I'm one of the first people on the mountain, and I'm going skiing. Ah! Come on with me. Woo!
Colder, gray and white, winter all around.
to getting older, and all this snow is trying to get me down. There's a fire in the corner slowly dying away. Sometimes I just don't feel like going on anymore, yet I know it's more than worth the waiting for another chance to see the summer sun. Come on, shine on me.
Close friends up here is a cowboy named Joe Henry. For people like him, Christmas time is centered around life on the ranch.
All in saddle, we spend Christmas Day driving cattle over snow-covered plains. Today, ours is the sky and the wide open range. Back in the cities, they have different ways, football and eggnog, Christmas parade. I'll take the blanket, I'll take the reins. It's Christmas, cowboys. Wide open plains. A campfire for warmth as we stop for the night. Stars overhead, the Christmas tree light. The wind sings a hymn as we bow down to pray. It's Christmas. Cowboys and wide open plains. It's tall in the saddle, spend Christmas Day. Driving cattle over snow-covered plains. So many gifts have been opened today. Ours is the sky, the wide open range. It's Christmas for cowboys and wide open plains.
Kind of school that I would love to have gone to. Beautiful setting up in the mountains, and it's free form. That means the kids get to concentrate on the things they're interested in. It looks to me like they're interested in getting me with as many snowballs as they can.
Okay, first we start off with this thing. I need a seat. Who's got a seat?
Me.
Put the seat right there.
Okay.
Now, what we're doing is building an improvised sled. It has one runner, kind of like a ski with a seat on it. And what we did was we took pieces of old barrels, called barrel staves, and we make a runner out of a long piece and then use a short piece for a seat with another piece of wood as an upright brace. Now, we used to call them snow scooters where I grew up, but in other parts of the country they call them skippers, snow jumpers, the ski bobs. The whole idea is to jump on board and ride as fast and as far as you can.
Oh, yeah!
Whatever you call them,
oh, yeah.
They're great.
Oh,
Steve Martin, and a lot of you folks here probably know Steve. Steve, I think Steve is so far out. I mean, he always does these weird, crazy, unimaginable things.
Hey, hold it a second. Wait a second. I'm telling these people I do weird and crazy things. But, you know, it's near Christmas time, and I think there's a time and place for seriousness. And I'd like to do a song. It's kind of a musical show. I'd like to do a song that my grandmother used to sing to me when I was a kid. And it's a song that's always meant something to me, and I admit it's corny, but in these times where everything's supposed to be so hip, you know, I think a song like this can really mean something to everyone, and I'd like to do it for you.
I'd love to hear it, Steve.
It's a song my grandmother used to sing to me when I was a kid. I'd like to do it.
Be courteous, kind, and forgiving. Be gentle and peaceful each day. Be warm and human and grateful, and have a good thing to say. Be thoughtful and trustful and childlike. Be witty and happy and wise. Be honest and love all your neighbors. Be obsequious, purple, and clairvoyant. Be pompous, obese, and eat cactus. Be dull and boring and omnipresent. Criticize things you don't know about. Be oblong and have your knees removed. Be tasteless, rude, and offensive. Live in a swamp and be three-dimensional. Put a live chicken in your underwear. Get all excited and go to a yawning festival.
Okay, everybody. Be courteous, kind, and forgiving.
Be courteous, kind, and forgiving.
Be gentle and peaceful each day.
The grizzly bear is one of the threatened species in the world. Matter of fact, here in Colorado, they're extinct. And some of us are trying to reintroduce the grizzly bear into this part of the world. Ow! And this is our first experiment in that regard. This little lady is a year-and-a-half-old grizzly cub. And she is a turkey. Grizz, I want you to listen. I'm going to sing a song for you.
How do you say hello to a grizzly bear? Do you think he'll understand me? Or will he even care? And what if he doesn't like me because of my long hair? Hello, goodbye, so long, leave me alone, Mr. Grizzly Bear. Mr. Grizzly Bear. Mr. Grizzly Bear.
Mountain Christmas will continue in a moment.
Boy, oh boy. Look at all this grandeur. I didn't know there were this many mountains in the world. It's a funny feeling up here. Just me and the Rockies. And that little speck on the horizon. That be?
Hey, look at that. Somebody else up here. And it's a girl. What a coincidence. I mean, she could have picked any Rocky in the range, and here she is on mine. Fate has brought us together. But she's really beautiful, too.
Matter of fact, he's probably a really wonderful guy. Well, meet, this could be one of those magic moments right out of the movies.
Pretty soon we're going to meet, and it's going to be one of those magic moments, just like in the movies.
Who would have thought that a chance meeting on a snowy mountain would have led to this?
Yes, how lucky we are that we have found one another.
What a superb dinner. Everything was so perfect.
Oh, I'm glad you enjoyed it. Will you marry me?
Well, I don't usually get married on the first date, but...
Then you will?
Yes. Yes. 1,000 times yes.
Waiter, check, please.
After a whirlwind dinner, we'll become husband and wife. It will be an unforgettable wedding.
It was certainly nice of the Queen to let us have Buckingham Palace for the ceremony.
Well, she was going to be out of town for the weekend anyway.
And it'll be the kind of honeymoon I've always dreamed of. I told them to keep the ocean open late for us, you know.
You are the perfect husband. You think of everything.
Well, nothing's too good for you, my dear.
And as the years fly by, our love will grow with each passing day.
Happy 10th anniversary, dear.
Darling, this is just beautiful. What a romantic gift. But where can we possibly keep the Eiffel Tower?
Yes, that was a problem. It looked awfully good where it was. I decided to buy you Paris, too.
But trouble can occur even in paradise. One day I'll come home and the house will be gone and there'll be a note pinned to the front lawn.
Dear ex-darling, I've always felt that trouble can occur even in paradise. I hope you can find it in your heart to forgive me, as I have fallen in love with someone else, taken the house, closed out the joint accounts, and sold the children. All my love, your future ex-husband. Hey! Hey, sweetheart! How are you today?
After all we've been to each other, you animal! Creep! More life?
Christmas, kids. Oh, well, here it is, almost Christmas, and I haven't had a vision of even one sugar plum dance through my head. Just one measly sugar plum, that's all I ask. Of course, I don't know what a sugar plum looks like. If an entire crop of sugar plums danced Swan Lake through my brain, I wouldn't know it, wouldn't recognize them. See how silly that is. I mean, I don't really need dancing sugar plums to tell me that I have the Christmas spirit, that I'm in it. Don't need a fireplace to hang a Christmas stocking from. I mean, a lot of people don't have fireplaces. Santa Claus doesn't say, tough luck, folks, get a fireplace and I'll see you next year. And you don't really need a red stocking to hang up. In a pinch, a brown paper bag will do. Or pantyhose. Santa will not pass you by. And who needs mistletoe? I mean, as an excuse for a friendly Christmas kiss. I sure don't. And yes, I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas is a wonderful song. It's beautiful. But there are a lot of places in the world where it doesn't snow. What's wrong with a green Christmas? No snow? Make your snowman out of cotton balls. See, that's the wonderful thing about Christmas. You don't need official equipment to enjoy playing the game. So, it doesn't matter how tall your tree or how big the turkey, or even if you have those things at all. Personally, I could go for pizza for Christmas dinner. Of course, I could go for pizza anytime. But the fact is, Christmas isn't in decorations, presents, things. It's people. People sharing, having fun, laughing, and just being together. Although, I could really get off on seeing a dancing sugar plum.
While we're up here skiing and skating and enjoying all that out of doors gives us this time of year, there's a whole other existence going on beneath the snow and the ice. For instance, in little streams like this, brook trout are continuing their cycle of life.
Thank you. Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it was to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Guitar, and though it's not often heard that way anymore, it's still the way that I like it best.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yonder. Sleep in heavenly peace.
Last summer, a friend of mine asked me to write a song for his granddaughter, Angela. And he said that he wanted it to be a Christmas song. And in telling me about it, he said that this little lady who had come into his life had totally altered his life just by the fact of her being, and that certainly Christmas was more to him than it had ever been. Well, I started looking at that, and I remembered back when I was a little boy and what Christmas was to me. And I remember that it was a time of incredible joy. It was a magic time. There were trees with lights on them and bubbly mirrors, and that people were around buying presents, and the whole family got together, and everybody was happy. And as I grew older, the meaning of Christmas also seemed to grow. It began to include the story of a little boy, a little baby, whose name was Jesus, and he was the Son of God. And I was filled with a sense of wonder. As years passed, though, Christmas seemed to lose a lot of its magic for me. It started to be something that mostly it was an excuse for people to go out and get presents and give presents to one another. And it came to be kind of a sad thing for me. But now, I too have an addition to my family. I have a little boy whose name is Zachary. And he's come to be the most important thing in my life. And what I've realized is that what Christmas is all about is giving, but it's not presents, and it's not toys. It's this incredible gift that we can all give to one another and that we can all share. The gift of life, and the gift of living. And one evening I sat down with a friend of mine, a fellow named Joe Henry, and together we wrote this song. The season is upon us now, a time for gifts and giving. And as the year draws to its close, I think about my living. The Christmas time when I was young, the magic and the wonder. With colors dull and candles dim and dark my standing under. Oh, little angel, shining light, you set my soul to beaming. You've given back my joy in life and filled me with new meaning. A Savior King was born that day, baby, just like you. And as the Magi came with gifts, I come with my gift too. The peace on earth fills up your time, the brotherhood surrounds you, that you may know the warmth of love and wrap it all around you. It's just a wish, a dream I'm told, from days when I was young. Merry Christmas, little Zachary. Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, everybody.
people that you can possibly imagine to put a television show like this together. To all of my friends up here, to the production crew who gave much more of themselves than just doing their job, I thank you for allowing me to share my Rocky Mountain Christmas.